What time do you call this? It's freezing down here at Camden Market, but do not fear. I'm about to take you to warmer climes over the Atlantic, down to Brazil, where I'm going to be inspired to cook the most amazing, beautiful lemon and garlic barbecue chicken. Frango churrasco is a traditional barbecue South American dish. Chicken, lemon and garlic. It's absolutely delicious. Traditionally done over an open fire. I can't do that here in the market, so I'm using this solid top. First off, I'm using these beautiful little chickens, poussin, and I'm going to spatchcock them. We've got to take out the spine. There's two ways to do it. First off, trim off any excess fat, feel for the spine, get your knife and just push it in. Push it all the way down, and then with the palm of your hand, push through. Same on the other side, just push it through and tap through. Flip it round and go again the other way. There you have a beautiful chicken completely opened up. Now, cut through these wings, just through the joint, put the heel of the knife on and just cut through. And then heel of the knife on there, bang. Cooking on the bone keeps flavour in, it keeps the meat moist. It's the best way to cook meat, really. If you don't feel confident using your knife, use a pair of kitchen scissors, big scissors, right? Cut off the excess again, go either side of the spine and just cut your way through. That comes straight out. It's completely opened up, and then these little bits, you can roast them off and use them in a chicken stock. Poussin chicken's done, now let's make the marinade. I'm just gonna clean my hands. I took some red peppers, I charred them on the stove and I cooked them in the oven for about 10 minutes. And then I put them in that bowl last night and I cling filmed them. I want that charred flavour, but I want the bitter skin off. Just going to cut the top off and then just reach in and take out the seeds. That's done. Now I want 3 lumps of garlic. Just going to push through. So just release them from their jackets. Now I'm just going to take the heels off. Drop your garlic in the food processor and then add 3 teaspoons of dried chilies. Add about 5 tablespoons of olive oil. Right, now I'm going to zest and juice 3 lemons. Whoa! Okay, so look in there. Look how much flavour is going on in there now. We're just going to squeeze the juice of the lemons in as well. Catch it so the pips don't go in. We need a good tablespoon of smoked paprika. That's going in. Now, a lot of recipes will tell you to put brown sugar in there, right? But what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this blackstrap molasses. Gives it a really great taste. So I want 2 tablespoons of that going in. Lid on and let's blitz the living daylights out of it. Okay, now because Food Tube only allow me to have the smallest mini blender on the planet, I couldn't get all my ingredients in. So the last couple of ingredients to go in is your beautiful red pepper and then just some leftover coriander stalks. They're perfect. Just get that in and we'll blitz. This is just like a shotgun of flavour. Look how intense and dark it is. Once that hits the chicken and then that hits the grill, boom, it's going to be so good. I'm going to season my chicken as well. Now you can put the seasoning in with the marinade that you've just done if you wanted to. And then I'm just going to add some freshly cracked pepper, both sides, and then on with your marinade. All over these little tasty chickens. You know, you could use chicken breast, you could use chicken thighs. Make sure that you marinate this for a minimum of 2 hours so it really has chance to suck in all those flavors. That's done. I'm gonna go and let that sit in the fridge for 2 hours. Next on is ají sauce. Now, this is traditionally a South American sauce. The main ingredient is the ají amarillo chili. Now, they're a bit tricky to get hold of in the UK. So if you want to recreate those characteristics, then you need 2 chilies, a jalapeno for the heat, and you need a habanero for the fruitiness. You need 1 of each. Top, cut through, open up. If you're a chili freak like Mr. Oliver, then you might want to keep the pith and the seeds in because that's where the heat is. But if you want to tone it down, then take those out. So that goes in. Get your habanero and just slice it open. And again, take out the seeds from there. And that goes in. Now we need a big fat clump of garlic to go in there. Just pop him out, take him out of his skin, and then drop him in. some recipes call for mayonnaise. I'm going to use some yogurt, 4 tablespoons. I'm going to get a spring onion in there. I've got these big guys, so roughly cut this guy down and get that in. Now, this is an interesting ingredient to put into a dip, is we're going to use a romaine lettuce. Now, I can use the leaves for a salad, but I'm going to take this crunchy element and we're going to add this. Then we're going to zest 2 limes. I'm now going to put the juice of 2 limes in there, get those in. I'm going to blitz this down, and then once it's down, I'm going to put in the lettuce and blitz that down. And then the lettuce on top. Now guys, you can get the really vibrant green ones, and if that's what you're looking for, then just add 1 tablespoon of yogurt in there. Let's go get the chicken to hit the grill. Gonna give it a couple of minutes to get searingly hot. You can see how the chicken has started sucking in the marinade and taking on all that color. You need them about 8 minutes on either side. So I've let these chickens chill out for a little bit and rest. So I'm gonna serve one up. We put some beautiful corn on the cobs, some lemons and some limes. Garnish with some refreshing coriander because we might need it. There's your Aji sauce. That is the original rocket fuel chicken we've got there. I reckon for that full plate, you're talking 8.50. Let's take it to the streets of Cameron Town and see what people will pay. I've got 2 lads over here, stay here. Right, boys, come on, come on, come on. There's one for you.
Okay.
Here you go, right. You need a little bit of sauce, come here.
Oh, that's the sauce.
Just get stuck in. You go with your chicken. What do you mean it's spicy?
What's... No, that is good, man.
Holy cow. It's tasty?
Mm-hmm. It's tasty.
What would you pay for the full platter of chicken?
£8.
£8. Okay. What would you pay?
Around this can and on this thing, £6.
£6. Yeah. £6. Boys, thanks very much. Right, we need one more person to try. Okay, yes, hello, what's your name?
Ash.
Ash.
Yep.
Okay, nice to meet you, Ash.
Thank
now,
you.
Chicken drumstick, yeah, look at that.
Thank
look
you.
At that flavour on there. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, right? Okay.
Such a charmer.
Okay. Good. Tasty.
It's not too bad, actually.
It's not too. What do you mean? You don't have to answer a bloody surprise. Now, what would you pay for a full platter of chicken? Is it really spicy?
It comes in after.
It's all right.
£7.
Okay, we could have paid more there. Right, brothers and sisters, that was my garlic and lemon Brazilian-inspired barbecue chicken with probably far too many bird's eye dried chilies. Cut them chilies down. Now, what do you think of that dish? What would you have paid? Let me know in the comment box below. And guys, what do you want me to cook next? Do you want something from Japan? Do you want something from France? Or do you want something from America? Let me know and I'll cook it for you. Catch you next time.